वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स, दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज एंड मेजरमेंट। नाउ व्हाट इज मेजरमेंट? मेजरमेंट इज अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ ऑलमोस्ट एवरी एस्पेक्ट ऑफ आवर लाइफ। सपोज यू वांट टू प्लान योर वीकेंड, यू वांट टू ट्रैवल सम प्लेसेस, सो फर्स्ट यू हैव टू नो द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन that place and your home, and then the required time to reach there. After knowing those information, then only you can plan your journey accordingly. So to plan your journey, you have to first measure the distance between your home and that place. So that is the basically measurement of length. And the time required, that means you have to measurement the time. So and the let's take another simple example. When we take a piece of cloth and go to tailor to make shirt or trouser, then first the tailor take measurement of our length of hands or other measurements. Why? That is why that it make comfortable trousers or shorts for our body. Okay, so measurement is very important. Okay, now let us first tell what is measurement. Suppose here you see two lines. If there is no unit or nothing, so how can we tell that this is how much length and this is how much length? So there should be a fixed quantity or fixed quantity that we can measure by comparing with that quantity. Okay, suppose if I am taking this is one unit, suppose I am taking this is one unit, so by comparing with this I can tell this is almost five times of this unit, so this I can be right that 5 unit. Okay, basically I am drawing it in centimeter. Basically this length is 1 centimeter. I am going to that later because we are starting to unit, so I am not using unit now. Okay, now so measurement requires basically two things. One is magnitude, one is unit. In this case this is unit. I am writing here unit. Basically this unit is centimeter. I draw this line with the help of this scale, so leave it now. So basically this is the magnitude, 1 and 5, this is the magnitude, and here after the magnitude here place the unit. Okay, now a measurement requires two things, that magnitude and unit. And let us see the complete definition of measurement. Okay, measurement is a comparison between an unknown quantity with a known fixed quantity of same kind. So here the same goes. This is the unknown length, and this length I know, I can call this length one unit. So by comparing this line with this line, I can tell this is 5 unit. Okay, now I am coming to what is physical quantity. Physical quantity is any type of quantity that can be measured. So any type of measured quantity called physical quantity. Now physical quantities are of two types: fundamental physical quantity and derived physical quantity. Which are fundamental physical quantity? Those does not depend on other quantities. Okay, for example, this is mass, length and time. Okay, those are the fundamental physical quantities. And derived quantities that depends on other quantities like fundamental quantities. So except the fundamental quantities, all are derived quantities. Okay, now move to the units. In ancient time we know that people usually use their body parts or any natural surroundings available easily to measure the length, weight or something. Suppose there are some example: cubit, hand span, foot. Basically, cubit is the length between our fingertip and elbow, okay, and hand span is the length between our thumb and the last finger, and foot is the length of an adult person barefoot. Okay, those are the using unit by the ancient man's. Okay, but there is a serious problem to use those traditional unit, because the length of foot or the length between elbow and our fingertip is not same for the all the persons. So that is why if I measure something and I told that is 2 cubit, and one person measured it and he found that it is greater than 2 cubit. Basically, I also measured correct, that man also measured correct, but the length between the finger and our elbow is not same for all the persons. That is the problem. So we have to stick in a specific unit system or a specific convention. Let's go to that. Now, in the meantime, there are two important unit system developed in 18th century. Basically, those are CGS and MKS. Okay, so in CGS system, the unit of length is centimeter, mass unit of mass is gram, and unit of time is second. And in MKS system, the unit of length is meter, mass is kilogram, and time is second. But in the meantime, the MKS system is become more popular than the CGS system. So, and there is a need to stick in a single unit system. So, after discussing in 1960, the International Bureau of Weights and Measure, which is situated in Paris, it called a general conference, and they adopted a international unit system. Those are the used by all over the world. Okay, so that is called abbreviated as SI system. Why SI system? Because the international system of units in Paris it is called Le Systeme International de Units. So take the first words of two letter S and I, so it is abbreviated as SI system. Now, what are the units or fundamental units in SI system? Those are the 5 units. You have to remember this all. Okay, the unit of length is meter, mass is kilogram, and those are the symbol small m, small k, small g. The unit of time is second, unit of electric current is ampere, those are the symbol, this is capital A. Unit of temperature is Kelvin, this is capital K. Amount of substance, the unit is mole, and luminous intensity, the unit is candela. Now here you see that this ampere is in capital letter, this Kelvin is in capital letter, but in second or kg or meter, those are the small letter. So there is a rule to write the symbols. Okay, if the unit is given, if the unit is named after a scientist, so the symbol should be in capital letter, because we know Lord Kelvin and ampere are the two important scientists of our modern era. So those units are, those symbols are of capital letter, and rest are the they are not named after scientists, so their symbols are in small letters. Okay.